Hello, I'm Şeyma Ünsal Bilge. Today I will present my poster to you, which summarizes my thesis study. In this study, we worked on the similarities and differences of drug modulations on cancer cells by the aid of protein interaction networks. Given the inter and intra-heterogeneity of cancer, modulations in signaling pathways and the interplay between cellular biomolecules are very important to understand the disease. To repurpose a given drug, we need to know its effect on the other condition, or we need to find another drug candidate that has similar activities with the known one. These factors lead to the main question of how can we classify drugs in a condition-based manner, and how can we understand the drug action mechanism. Traditional methods prioritize chemical and functional similarities while grouping drugs. However, chemically and functionally similar drugs may lead to different protein-protein interaction networks within the specific cells or vice versa. We used p100 dataset of connectivity map resource. p100 dataset includes phosphorylation and transcription data for 5 cancer cell lines and 89 small molecule drugs with a control treatment. We used drug target data of these small molecules, and we also used IRF Web version 13 human interactome in network reconstruction studies. This figure summarizes the protocol for a single network modeling. We need two input files, which are seed protein lists and the interactome. Seed proteins include drug targets, significantly phosphorylated proteins, and transcription factors that regulate the significantly transcribed genes. Interactome is processed to exclude hub proteins and low expressed genes. An Ademica-Darling prediction method is applied to enrich the interactome with possible false negative interactions. For network reconstruction, omics integrator software is used. It applies the price-collecting Steiner-Forest formalism and balances the trade-off between costs of edges and prices of nodes. After we modeled all available cell line drug networks, we applied a topology-based separation score measure to compare the networks pairwisely. This method calculates mean of shortest distances between proteins when two networks are mapped on the interactome. Then these pairwise scores are transferred to a matrix representation for clustering purposes. Here you see the representation of mechanism of actions of drugs used in this study. We have protein kinase inhibitors, epigenetic modulators, and examples for some other mechanisms. We used these mechanism of actions in our further analysis of network comparisons to define the ground truth. Now I would like to explain the color code on the matrices. On the lower triangles, you see the separation scores. Negative results are on the blue scale and negativity means network overlap. Positive results lie on the red scale and the higher the separation score, the more separated the two networks are. We also defined four types of network pairs that are reflected on the upper triangle. T1, T2, T3, and T4 refer to the combinations of the similarity based on cell line and mechanism of action of the drugs. This plot shows the distribution of separation scores based on network pair types. To systematically evaluate the performance of this method, we compared the results against the ground truth that same mechanism of action drugs will have similar networks. We prepared the separation score matrix of all conditions. From this heat map, we observe a group of cell line drug conditions that have overlapping networks. These similarly acting drugs are listed in the table, and there are drugs with different mechanism of action and/or chemical structures. As an example to a false positive case, here you can see the merged network of tosadenylene and galdanamycin in A375 cell line. Tosadenylene is an HDAC inhibitor. Galdanamycin is a heat shock protein inhibitor. They are located in different clusters according to their mechanism of action and max key distances. However, the networks have several common proteins, shown as blue nodes, and drug targets share common downstream regulators. Another example is the drugs with same mechanism of action but having distant networks, which is a false negative case. Tosadenylene and RGFP966 are both HDAC inhibitors, but they have different affinities to different HDAC proteins. RGFB966 and tetadienyl networks in different cell lines generally distant to each other with positive separation scores. These results revealed that when the selectivity for a specific target increases, separation between networks also increases and different signaling pathways are modulated. Now I would like to present an example for the application of network-based analysis of drug perturbation, which is the combinatorial drug treatment strategy. For this analysis, we used Cheng et al.'s paper as a reference. They defined complementary exposure idea that is consistent with the synergistic effects of drugs. According to this idea, two drug molecules should have a positive separation score. They should be distant to each other while they have their unique overlapping parts with the disease module. In our case, we reconstructed cell line drug networks that also include some part of the disease modules. That's why our two networks may or may not have an overlapping region between each other. Ideally, they should at least have a common disease gene. From over 6,000 possible drug pairs for the same cell lines, around 1,400 drug pairs are rated based on their separation scores, network sizes, and number of commonly enriched pathways. Lenalidomide and IBAT-762 drug pair is the highest ranked one. This drug pair also follows the complementary exposure idea, and there are some evidence in the literature for the synergistic activity of lenalidomide when in combination with BET inhibitors. Thank you for listening.